Our 64-mile trip begins at Meramec Springs, which is said to discharge nearly 100 million gallons per day. In 1829, it is said that the surrounding land was used as an ironworks and utilized the spring's flow for power. The sight of the spring is incredible. One can spend hours looking into its deep turquoise and blue water. Hopeful for good weather and river conditions, we loaded our boats and set out on a waterway we didn't know a great deal about, save a little history and some interesting folklore. The headwaters of the Meramec River begin in the Ozarks near Salem, Missouri, not far from land previously owned by Mitch Jane, one of the original Dillards, and is one of the largest free-flowing waterways within the state. The river flows approximately 228 miles before joining the Mississippi near St. Louis. Springs contribute to its journey as it progresses through stunning topography. Aquatic life is both abundant and diverse, and new native species continue to be discovered today. The river is said to have been given its name by early Native Americans and derived from two slightly different pronunciations of the commonly known name Meramec, meaning either water of the bitter spring, due to the sulfur springs that existed during that era, or waters of death, due to whirlpools and currents alleged to be responsible for the death of unwary swimmers. On this trip, we didn't encounter water that presented any degree of serious difficulty. For the most part, we were met with gentle current and a few small rapids with a moving average of about 3 miles per hour. The gauge height was 1.35, and according to water data sources, the floating conditions were poorer due to low levels. Despite this, we only had to drag the boats in a few places. All in all, a good run.
Thank you.
There are several caves along the river that are visible along its course. Meramec Caverns, located near the river, is said to be full of mystery and legend. The cave is thought to have been a hideout for the infamous Jesse James, the outlaw. In the drought of 1941, water levels in the surrounding streams and rivers dropped, as did the water table. At the time, what appeared to be a dead end within Meramec Caverns at normal water levels revealed a passage due to the receding water. Adventurer Les Dill, while exploring the cave, discovered the passage as cool airflow replaced the void in the wall where water had once been. Dill went under the wall and through the water to discover even more cavern passages. Artifacts traceable to the notorious outlaw were found within the newly discovered passages. The cave system then earned the nickname Jesse James Hideout. There is much folklore associated with the Meramec, as it is abundant within the Ozarks. A story shared with us by a local was of a skeleton belonging to an 8-foot giant discovered within a bluff cave along the Meramec, known as Puckett's Cave. So the story goes, in 1933, a young boy looking for arrowheads discovered the skeleton. The skeleton was recovered and examined by experts in their field. Of course, there was a barrage of questions, speculations associated with the remains, both practical and some fantastic. To our understanding, the find remains a mystery and is not the only report of such discoveries made within the Ozark region. We have been blessed with fair weather for the majority of our trip, save a little rain. On our final night, our hope for good conditions rapidly diminished. Thank you. As we neared the end of this journey, we were pleased with what this amazing river had to offer. Although conditions were not ideal, we enjoyed the challenge and the time together, as always.